Hey there, boys and girls of YouTube world. Today, Duff Dog and I are going to see if we can't get a 1966 Ford Bronco running. It's only been sitting here for like 5 years and been off the road for 25 years, so should go well. So, Duff Dog and I, we just picked up, well, we haven't picked it up, just bought this 1966 Ford Bronco. I always wanted an early Bronco. This is the first year, 66 to 77 is early Broncos. It's got a fancy receiver hitch. It's a one size fits all. Oh, yeah. Ray Charles Welding got a hold of that one. All the penetrations. Dang! That must have been in his early days, because if you can't weld good, weld a lot. And he wasn't welding a lot then. Is that the muffler? Nope. Fuel tank? Oh yeah, that's definitely the fuel tank because it's held in with a ratchet strap. A little rot. Oh yeah. Is that some fiberglass? Probably. These things are always so rusty. Well, there's the rest of the bumper. Spare steering column, steering wheel, starter. I'm sure the starter's fine. This is the half cab option. It's removable. You could get a full cab top, which is pretty common. The reason I kind of wanted this one is because it's uncut. Most of them, they cut the back quarter panels, radius them out to match the front. And you don't see many that are unmolested like this. So that's kind of why I wanted it. Again, looks like some previous body work was done on the rocker panel. You know, they run some screws in there and try to pull them out. Obviously, they did an excellent job there. Quarter window's a little floppy. Missing a window crank. Look at those fancy door straps. Look at that fancy seat. Just some padding on the floor. What's got the Go Fast Superior Performance Products steering wheel? Only 60K. One gauge in the whole thing, but it does have everything in it. It's a 3-speed. It was on the column, and then somebody tried converting it to the floor. Just like they tried putting an ignition switch in it. It's got a Krako. I mean, those were basically top of the line. It's AM, FM, and cassette. There's the janky shifter that needs to be installed yet. Oh, they went put the mud on the inside even. Somebody already stripped out the hardware mounting the doors. They sealed her up real good with the silicone. Oh, the windshields tilt forward too if you really want to get after it. They were all four-wheel drive, as far as I know. Custom front bumper. It's got a 6-cylinder in it. I don't know, like a 170, something like that. Missing the hubcaps on this side. Just got a few whiskey dents in the front with some subpar repairs. It's a hybrid. Yeah, that's right, 110 volt. Oh yeah, that's what the neat hook on the hood is for when you tip the windshield down, you just pin it to the hood. Pretty crude, look at how boxy those inner fenders are. And they always rot right there where the hood hinges would be on a normal vehicle. What size is that thing? I don't know, I can't read it. Looks like it's all there though. He says he thinks it's a wire and that's why it doesn't run, just a wire. Or maybe it's that Napa fuel filter, that's probably the issue. Does it turn over? Oh, hopefully it's just in gear. I'm sure it didn't drink any water. No power steering, no power brakes, single reservoir fruit jar. It's got the CarQuest low radiator hose and a kinked upper radiator hose. Steering box way out front. It's got a horn, some nice butt connectors. Battery tray's rotted out as usual. Hood latch works. Seems pretty dry. Missing the Bronco badges, but I guess we'll find out. We know that there's some mud in it, so this quarter's got a little hooey to it. Not bad. Floor's been patched. Good news is you can buy all the parts for these things. Door opens. Yeah. Pretty simple. I'm excited. Like I said, I always wanted one of these things. How about you, Duff? You just want the rabbit that's under that car? Get him. Hunt him up. Get down in there. Don't be a skunk. Let's see if we can't get this thing drug out of here. I don't know how I'm gonna get in here because there's junk everywhere. Some railroad ties between me and the pickup, so this might be fun. All right, here we go. Can't go that way because there's a fence. What's in there? Ooh, a Chrysler Brohammer. Dang. Another Studebaker, because we love those things. So do you guys on the channel. Is it a bullet nose? Oh, it was a bullet nose, but it's gone. Dang it. Horse trailer, derby cars, railroad tracks. How are we gonna get through here, duffers? Boy. Wish that fence wasn't there.
So we got Das Bronco home. Put a couple tubes in the tires because they were flat when we pulled it out. And they didn't seem to be holding air for the ride home. And I hate flat tires because none of my junk runs. So it looks really like junk when they got flat tires as well. So, oh, check this out. The tires are even Broncos. Keep your Bronco all Bronco. Look what color this thing was. Way to ruin it. Goofy cowboys. Painted camouflage. OD green. Let's see if we can't get it running. Hood prop rod. Yes. That was an option we didn't pay for. Oh, it looks like it was supposed to be right there. And went over to here. Don't worry. Got a fix for that.
Bet you thought I was going to get a hockey stick. No, I ain't Canadian. I don't like the Coastal Auto Reaction guys or the old car guy up there in Canada. Check those guys out. They probably use hockey sticks as hood prop rods. Or the other Canadians you got to check out are the Sobering Restoration Horsepower Division guys. Come on, shorten your name up so I can remember it. Yeah, check them out. Links are down below.
Well, we're going to need a battery. Is there oil in it? Is there a dipstick? Ooh, there is a dipstick. I'm sure it's fine. It's on the stick. It's just below safe. Perfect. Sounds like it had a real rough last ride, so not getting my hopes up. Well, that's a nice power wire. Okay. Well, maybe we'll just get rid of that and put a real power wire on it. Coolant? Not so much. It does have a newish low radiator hose, though. So, and the overflow isn't super brittle, although it's fuel hose. Get the right hose for that. That irritates me. Nelson things. Just plug the vacuum hose with the bolt. I'm going to go find a battery cable and a battery. All kinds of room for a great big battery in here, at least.
Remember how I said I was going to put a battery cable on it? I found a universal battery cable end. So, I fixed that. No need to clean that up. I got no friend starter. Well, is it in gear? I don't think so. Just kidding. It's in gear. Always check to make sure that it's out of gear. I'll do that now. Okay, better this time. Tech tip of the day before starting a crappy old manual or automatic transmission car, always make sure it's out of gear. Glad it didn't start. On a positive note, the engine must be kind of loose. Here we go again. Move our feet. Good to go. Glad I don't have any friends because somebody would have ran me. Oh, if you'd have had a friend, they could have held the clutch pedal down. Guess we're going to have to get one of those. See if we got spark. Hey, this might actually be the one where we don't have to clean points. Right. So we're gonna hook our cheater wire up to the negative side of the coil. Just kidding, positive side of the coil. Oh! They had the wires backwards on the coil. So if we hook the distributor wire to the distributor side of the coil, you're kidding me. Yep, sure enough, that side says battery. Let me hook the battery up to it. We might get spark. Not often that when they say it was a wire, that's all it was. Check for spark. Surprise, surprise, nothing. Let's give the points a little tickle. See if we got any Maybe they burned out the coil doing that. I've never hooked one up backwards, so I don't know what happens.
If you know what happens when you hook up a coil backwards, let me know. I've blown them up because I hooked a 6-volt up to 12 volts and left it hooked up too long. They go boom.
And boom goes the dynamite.
And boom goes the dynamite.
These points don't look that good. I suppose that's because they had it hooked up backwards. Took some sandpaper to our points. Now let's see what we got. Still nothing. These points really do not look good. I'm gonna check the gap on these things. See where they need to be. See where they're at. Well, what size is this engine? Looks like it should either be a 170 or a 240. It says 200, so maybe it's been updated. Either way, it's a mid-level. Where is our points gap adjustment? Ignition timing, valve lash. Ooh, it's a 78 model valve cover. She's been updated. Why didn't they put the high energy ignition out of the 78 in there? That would have been good. Dang it. Doesn't say points gap. Well, I guess we'll go check out the interwebs.
Because the interwebs knows all. Near as I can tell on the internet, it's 20 to 27,000, so we got 25.
Which seems about right. Tell we got a set of points for this.
Oh, I might have a points eliminator kit on hand. Thanks, Gramlo LTD.
Just spark already. Can we get one spark is all? There we go, just had to fleck them a few times. Pow! Pow! Now we just need compression and fuel. Sounds easy enough. Rotor on, yep. How chewy does that look?
A little chewy.
So I guess give her some hot sauce. See what happens. Try this fill through the vent tube float bowl thing that everybody gets excited about. Doesn't sound that great, but it's running. Where's the fuel line at? Oh yeah, we got fuel pressure. Look at that hissing down there.
I would say that stream right there says the fuel pump's working. Oh, it's coming out all directions. Oh, that's one of them nice fuel lines. I wonder if that fuel's flammable. Or we're filling the fuel tank full of terribleness. Let's put a new fuel line and find out. Oh, that's why. It's Napa fuel hose, and it's for fuel injection. Oh no, it's just fuel line hose. Just kidding. Nice work, Napa. Hopefully the fuel filter they sold us is better. Hold on while I put a new fuel line on.
All right, before we get going, I'm gonna see if we can get some fuel up here. Go. I don't have much confidence in this poor quality fuel line that I got a batch of. It's like it's squished flat before you even start. Fortunately, the Napa hose was probably better shape than this stuff. Now, I guess we find out if that gas is flammable. Oh, don't let your favorite yellow coil wire get in the fan. I think it'll run off this gas even. They said it was only parked for a few years. So you know that means at least 5. What's pumping that gas in there? It's just not flammable. Awesome. We get to drain another fuel tank. My favorite. What to do with many gallons of gas. I wonder if the fuel gauge works. So the key seems to be working inside. Well, it's cranking it over anyway. Fuel gauge says empty, so I'm guessing that's not working. Let's pull the line off, see if we can't catch some of that bad gas.
Oh, did I lose the nipple for the hot sauce? Look at the mouse nest that came out of the exhaust pipe. Yep. She's got a couple nests in the exhaust.
I got some random mystery bottles to fill up with bad gas so that I can do bad gas things with them.
Oh, go into the pan, dummy.
Well, we got coolant leaking back there, so that's pretty awesome. Awesome!
So I was trying to figure out why there was coolant leaking down the back of the engine, and then I put my finger back here on the freeze plug and felt the hole and made it even bigger. So I guess we're gonna need to put a freeze plug in. That one looks like it's gonna be real accessible. Awesome! Pull the engine to put a freeze plug in. Ford things.
So I took a little hiatus from the old Bronco here. I got some frost plugs to replace the ones that are rotted out. Seems how we can't replace them on the engine, we're gonna have to figure something out. I think we're just gonna pull it out of there, as opposed to lifting the body off or pulling the head or trying to make a special tool to sneak around in there, pop the old ones out, get the new ones in, not have any leaks. Shouldn't take too much to pull this out. Knock on wood. So let's rip into the old horse here and see what happens. Here we go.
Yeah. So, I wonder if they were having any heating issues. I feel like that shouldn't be in there. Oh my goodness. What is all that? No wonder the soft plugs are all rotted out. So we got our peel six banger out of there, all because of that rotten frost plug. But while we're at it, we're gonna do all of them. And there is a stack of them. This thing is like Swiss frickin' cheese. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 there. But there's also some way up in there. Maybe you can see that one better. So we gotta pull the flipping manifold off to get those on there. And the manifold is what's holding up in the air. So, yeah. That'll be fun. We did break an exhaust stud, son of a biscuit. Guess we'll have to fix that when we got it apart too. Awesome, huh, Duff? And we should probably address all the rust in the system. Maybe we'll knock all these out and run some water through it. What do you guys use to clean out engine blocks? What's good? I don't know. I gotta flush a few this summer, so comment down below. Right, Duff? We like suggestions. All right, let's knock some freeze plugs in, out, around. So there's a lot of ways to remove a frost plug or install a new one. My grandpa, he used to like to just knock them into the engine and leave them in there. Seemed like it worked for 40 years doing it that way, but I try to get them out. So usually I try to hit them in a corner and spin it sideways and then grab it with a vice grip. We'll see what happens. Doesn't seem like whatever I do works the same every time. You got a great way to remove frost plugs. You tell me. Some people say you drill a hole, put a slide hammer on it. Whatever. As long as you get it out of there or get your new one in, don't really matter, does it? Yeah, see, that one's so frickin' rusty. Junk. Can we just pry it out of there? Got it. There it is. Along with all the sludge that's inside of there. Right, Duff? Ew. Yeah, we're definitely gonna wanna flush this thing. Cool tool of the week. Get yourself a swivel for your engine crane. So much nicer than fighting a twisted chain all the time. Well worth the, whatever those things are, 20, 30 bucks. See how we do on ones that aren't so rusty. Let's get a bigger bar. So you just knock it sideways like that. Get her spun around in there, kitty wampus. Pull her out with your vice grip. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. There's what a Midwest block heater looks like. Basically, it's just like a heating element like your water heater's got. Heats up the block so they start when it's cold out, provided you remember to plug it in. Oh man, this block is just full of sludge. Apparently this block heater failed, so they put that one in. This thing was a cold weather machine. I have no idea how this one's held in. I think we're just gonna leave that one in place because the parts man only gave me 4 of these bigger plugs, which I'm gonna be one short anyway. Son of a biscuit. You just can't get a good parts guy these days, or gal.
You can see that sludge that's in there. Oh man. Yeah. Oh, this poor engine. There's what I already drug out of that cylinder. Frost plug hole. Yeah, I think we gotta knock them all out. That one, I don't know how it's held in there, if we gotta drill it out or what. But that one's probably gonna give us issues. I think we just gotta drill through the center there. Sweet. That isn't as, well, it's not good. Not good at all. I suppose we can't get this side of the engine clean because there's nothing over here. Silly Fords. I should probably get a thermostat and a gasket. New hose can be nice too. All right. Keep picking away at her. So here's what inside of the thermostat housing looks like. Yeah. Ooh, didn't even go down the floor drain. Good save. And here's the thermostat itself. Real good. No way this thing's gonna have a heating issue. So we got our exhaust manifold off. It'll be easy to fix that one stud there that's busted, right? Oh yeah, and while we're fixing that stud, we'll fix the other 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 that broke. Good news is, two of them came out. Ford, you guys really know how to do exhaust, and that's why we're taking it off so that we can replace those little guys. Yep. Well, that one isn't too bad. Just a little rotten. That one is though. So I guess it's a good thing we're doing this. Oh man, and it looks real crusty in there too. This is gonna be, you know what's gonna happen, Duff? We're gonna do all this work to this stupid Ford. You're already agreeing with me. And it's just gonna overheat and it's gonna be gutless. And the clutch is gonna slip because we're not putting a new one in, but at least the hood opens up really high, so we can put a Chevy in it. What do you think, Duff? Should we put a Chevy in it? Yeah, good call. Awesome. Can't wait to fix all those studs. It's gonna be great. Ford things.
Any mechanic will tell you that literally the worst part about their job is extracting broken bolts and studs, whatnot. Using screw extractors, drilling out bolts, tapping bolts, breaking taps, breaking extraction devices, just sucks. So I've been dreading this, but let's get after it, huh, Duff? So these are 3A studs. Gear wrench makes a lot of cool tools, and they got these little sockets for installing and removing studs. Slides right over the stud, and you can spin it right out, allegedly. Well, that's nothing to do with their tool. But what we're gonna do first is, I smacked all these in, and usually what I like to do is smack the bolt, because I like hitting things with hammers. But also because, as you tighten that bolt up, it's got some stretch in it, and so it's pulling out against those threads. So what I like to do is take a hammer and tap it in so that it takes some tension off those threads, is my theory. Then we're gonna give it a whole lot of heat. We might get some zep out, and then these things are just gonna turn right out. We got 1, 3, 5, 6, 8, 9 to do. Should be fun. And these two end ones, we can't even get this stud extractor on. We'll have to weld a nut on there or drill them out and tap them. At least that's a through hole. So worst case scenario, we just drill it out, tap it out, which is no fun anyway. But hopefully we can get these ones to spin out because they're a blind hole. Like Ray Charles.
You got the right one, baby.
We can't get at the back side of those. That's what blind means, I think. I don't know. Seemed like a good term. I'm not even going to put the new frost plugs in or take these ones out until we get this done, because I might just give up on this thing by the time we get through these. Because we do have the engine out of the $50 66 Ford pickup that we can slam in there. We know that one didn't leak coolant at least, so. I think it'll bolt in its place. The only thing interchanges on Fords is oil and antifreeze, and you better check your operator's manual first. So let's get started. one dove. That's hot. Don't touch it. So the stud extractor got two out of the six that we could try. Rest pretty much snapped off flush. These two we could try to put a nut on and weld it on. That's what we'll try next. Usually drilling is the last resort because you never get it straight, or you never find a sharp bit, or it snaps off, or you punch into a water jacket. Just never works out for me. So I'll get the welder out, see what happens. I may have to lay it on its side so that we can not have to overhead weld, Ray Charles style. Yeah, let's do that. Let's set it on the ground. Next from our tool of misfit toys, we're gonna take the next size bigger nut, try to weld it on there with my Miller 140, and then hopefully that nut grabs onto that stud and spins it right out. This usually doesn't work either. See what happens. So these are 3A studs, so I got some 7/16 nuts. What's left of my nuts? Looks like we need to stock up. All right, hold my beer and watch this, Duff. Boy, you want to weld? I don't think so. You weld as bad as Ray Charles. He's got thumbs, though. Your welder cranked up to 11.
Does that mean it's louder? Is it any louder?
Well, it's one louder.
So after welding about a dozen nuts on, we had zero successes. We're just a bunch of losers here, aren't we, Duff? Well, I'm gonna grind off what's protruding here. Hopefully get some of the weld, because that weld is really hard to drill. And then maybe we can use the manifold to line up and mark where we gotta drill, so hopefully we get some of these centered. Probably not. We do have four of the 11 out, so I mean, that's like 30%. Not bad for this place. You want to not gall up the mating surface, but sometimes you do. Oh, this is gonna be so much fun. So these holes are kind of slotted, oversized, whatever you want to call it. So I tried to get the manifold as centered as I could over the holes. And then I'm gonna use a center punch, mark the centers of those, and then hopefully we can stay straight through as we drill it out. That didn't work out so well, because a lot of these don't look very centered. Mm-hmm. And there you have it, kids. Tapping a whole bunch of stupid Ford exhaust manifold bolts. I'm sure you guys got better ways of doing it. I tried the left-handed drill bit deal. Wasn't happening. And you gotta have it really centered for that. And half my left-handed drill bits are snapped off. So, did it the old-fashioned way. Didn't break any taps. Didn't break any drill bits. Now we just got a mess to clean up. Also, when you lay an engine on the side and leave for a day, you have a Exxon Valdez style spill on your floor.
One of the worst oil spills in US history.
Don't worry, it's only a half bag. You guys do that? Rate your spills on how many bags of floor dry it takes to clean it up? Yeah, me too. All right, let's get the vacuum cleaner and suck all this up. Start putting some freeze plugs in. I guess get the old ones out first. We should probably pick it up in the air and try washing out the inside of the engine before we stick the new ones in, so that the new ones don't rot out too. Sweet. Also, I was looking at the side of the block here. Looks like there is a drain plug port right there. How neat is that? A little Allen wrench, you can drain the coolant out of the side of your 200 cubic inch Ford. Six in a row, ready to tow.
Six in a row, ready to tow, 8 to V, you probably sit down to pee.
Buzzing half dozen engine. Anybody would want to watch pressure washing videos, because it's a miserable job to do. Maybe that's why people like watching it. They like watching people be miserable. Duff likes watching me do it. Don't you, Duff? You're a good supervisor over there. See how rusty that water was that was coming out when we started, and how clean it was when we got done? Oh man, that stuff was cleaner than Flint tap water by the time we were done. This is gonna be real good. Hey Duff! What are you hunting over there? Alright. Clean up my mess.
Got the block all washed up. Look at how clean it is in there. It's actually freaking good. We chased a lot of rust and debris out of there, didn't we, Duff Dog? I took some emery cloth, cleaned up these bores. And we're gonna take and whammy some right stuff on our soft plugs and use a socket, drive them in there. What do you think about that, Duff? You're all huffy, huh? Yeah, it's not much fun, but gotta do it. Get yourself a good parts guy that knows that a soft plug and a freeze plug and an expansion plug are all pretty much the same thing, because guy I had yesterday was not aware that a freeze plug and a soft plug and an expansion plug or a coolant passage plug. He had a tough time finding a thermostat housing gasket and a thermostat. Is that a water outlet? Yeah, whatever, buddy. Just give me the gasket. Turns out it was the wrong one. Wasn't even Napa either, Duff.
I like to put a little silicone on them because you don't want these leaking again. Especially this one on the back of the engine that's impossible to get at. Get our valve loosener here. Give it a little tap, tap, tap-a-roo.
Give it a little tappy. Tap, tap, tap-a-roo.
So the first parts guy only gave me four. Turns out these engines require six. So I still got these two to put in, but we can put those in when it's in the Bronco. Usually, I like to wipe them off when I'm done, so it looks a little bit more professional, so I look like less of a hack mechanic that I am.
Duff says we need all the power we can get. And that silly little 200. So we're plugging off vacuum parts and whatnot. So I was just going to take this whole block out of there and just have one plug instead of having to plug two spots. And then I determined that this, I don't know, silly Ford log manifold block thing won't spin all the way around without taking this carb spacer off. And look at that sweet throttle linkage. Yeah, that's real good. Well, I was looking at that, you know, the spring ain't in line straight like it should be, but it kind of works. I was like, man, that don't move real far, and it don't return either, but that's besides the point. We need WFO, and why does that not go WFO? Duff said, see what's binding. I don't know what's going on over here. And the throttle shafts, she's pretty worn out. Don't worry, the fuel just leaks straight onto the exhaust manifold. It's not like it's gonna do Y-block things to us. Oh yeah, we're gonna get rid of all these screws and bolts that are wedging these plugs too. But that's hooked up to the throttle shaft. And that's why it only opened so far. So we're gonna nip that off. We're gonna get her to go WFO. So you can see that throttle blade, it's only opening like 40%. We need all the throttle, right, Duff? So I'm gonna pull that carbonator off there and address that, get that plug out of there. Chin helped me get the engine in, got that in, pretty much everything's buttoned up. The exhaust literally fell apart in my hand, so need to address that. I think I'm gonna try to get a new one bent up. Chunk of pipe. You know, we gotta do the radiator and a little bit of wiring yet, fan belt, etc. But the fuel line's done. Getting pretty close. Oh, I gotta do the thermostat housing, thermostat, whatnot. But pretty dang close. Clutch is hooked up. Gotta go underneath, put a couple bolts in that inspection cover. Real close. But look at all the vacuum parts on this thing. You know, one there, I think that's for the heat riser. This one for your PCV, one here, one here, one here. All for a little tiny one barrel. Plus two of them there, one more there. Just preposterous. Silly emissions. All right, it's not Nader's problem, Gore. Gore's who ruined it. I'll get it right one of these times. Back at her. I know. We'll go for an RIDE after a bit. You can spell. I knew it. Puddin' can't spell. Remember when he sent me that t-shirt? Those decals? Spelt my name completely wrong. Kids these days, tell you what. So this saga continues. Had to take the carburetor off. You can see we still gotta get that shaft off there, which I'll probably forget. I wonder if we can just leave it facing that way. Yeah, we'll just whack it off with the death wheel. But I noticed when I took this off, there wasn't a gasket, and there wasn't a gasket there. You suppose that was a vacuum leak. So, rounded up, I think it's a GM thermostat housing gasket. It'll be good enough for the girls I go with. And then, also had a spare gasket from Unibody carbonator rebuild. So, might be able to replace this furry little sucker, but it actually don't look that bad. We'll probably just leave that one for now. I'm guessing we should probably kit that carb at some point. But we won't. Guarantee there was a vacuum leak there. Unless this aluminum just conformed to it that well. But now we can plug that hole. And what a janky conglomerate. Yeah. That. Always save all your old gaskets left over from old projects. They come in handy. So I think everybody understands my disdain for flexi radiator hoses. But turns out I just have a radiator hose and hose clamp thing in general. I got a thing for hose. This was what the top radiator hose was. They just had it bent over like this. And obviously that was kinked. So that didn't help the issue of cooling. And that neck size is too big. So, I mean, the right thing to do would be to get a new radiator hose, but look what we found in the Mortske shed of amazingness. Look at that. I mean, it's not perfect. You know, this could be a little bit further out. I think we cut her off right about there. And it's gonna be the right size. It's gonna have that molded bend into it. Let's see if it fits better this way. I don't even know what this is off of. It's an upper radiator hose for some GM application. You got another one here. Let's try that one out. That one's got a little bit more of a right angle to it. How does that look? I think I like that one better. I think we're going to cut that one right about there. See what happens. It's going to be real good. Duff's over there having a small snack, aren't you? Oh, yeah. Look at that. Would you just friggin' look at it?
Freaking look at that.
All I had to do was grab some crappy old radiator hoses I laid out back, and way better than a flexi hose, and a straight hose kinked in half. That's all you gotta do. Just take a piece of mechanics wire, bend it up in the shape you need, and then go to your local parts warehouse or parts store or whatever you got, and they'll let you go in the back usually, you know, if you're a decent human being, and look for what you need. Boom. Good to go. Don't use flexi hoses. Ban all the flexi hoses. See, Duff runs and hides when I mention the flexi hoses because he knows how angry I get. Even he's getting angry. Don't we hate flexi hoses? Ugh, flexi hoses is bad. So bad. Yeah. Next thing we got to address is this throttle linkage. I think the pivot needs to be over about a half inch of this clamp. And then this is where the spring is supposed to hook. And that should be straight in line with that ball stud there. And this emissions something or other is in the way. So I think what we're going to do is we're going to take this all back apart again. And I'm going to run this through the saw. And then I'm going to run a pipe tap in it. And I'm going to put a plug in there. And then we're going to get this whole thing shifted over. You can see where they cut and welded it from whatever the 170 that was in here before. So it's already modified. We're just going to make it a little bit better because you don't want your throttle sticking. Ask me how I know. So here's that spacer I was talking about. And you can see the hole. It was hooked up for that emissions thing. So we're just going to put it in the old bandy saw and go right through there. And then hopefully we can find a pipe tap closest to the same diameter. Tap it out and thread a plug in there. All right. Probably just created a bunch of work for myself and I'm going to screw something up. But whatever. Duff says, you have screwed up already. I cut that at an angle because I thought that would look nice. Well, I mean, it's straight, but it's at an angle according to that hole. So tapping that might be interesting. I could trim some more material off and get it straight with that hole, but I think we'll figure it out. Right, Duff? Uh-oh. He doesn't have that reinforcing tail wag that we're so used to. Stupid Fords and their stupid emissions. So we had a little epiphany. I thought, I hate tapping things. I like tapping frost plugs in. So we found a little frost plug and we started tapping it in there. And then the crappy aluminum blew all apart. So we kept wailing it in there. I think we'll be good to go though. I'm glad we didn't tap it for threads, because as soon as we'd have put a pipe plug in there, it would have blowed out, or probably would have blowed out in the tapping process. So fixed it, right, Duff? You're not impressed. Yeah, it does kind of look like crap, but whatever. It makes me feel good because I got to smack it with a hammer. So we got our carbonator bolted on. You can barely see where I buggered it all up from snapping that fitting conglomeration off. But anyway, it's way better than having that big piece out here. So I hooked up the throttle cable and you can see kind of how it wants to lay out. No, it's a straight line. You know, that's kind of how things want to work. Cables do go around corners, but and here's where our bracket was at. So, I mean, it's a solid, I don't know, inch and a half, 2 inches off. And then we're going to have to attach this to something because that was attached with a bracket to that emissions garbage. And you can see, look at how sweet this thing is. Ray Charles got in here and welded her up real nice. So I think what I'm going to do is knock the spot weld off between these two brackets and shift all that over, because we're kind of limited on spots to mount it. I mean, we really only got that head stud there. Isn't it neat how the valve cover's got clearance for that throttle cable right there? I'm going to shift all that over, and then we're going to whiz that off. And then I think we're going to try to tie right onto. We got a couple options for exhaust studs, but I think this one's a little bit to the right, and this one's a ways to the left, so see how it all lays out, but we'll tie onto one of those, and it should be real good. So I think I'm just going to take the air chisel and poke in between there, and hopefully this thing comes apart. So we went out to Boom Tube Brian's, and he made us a nice new exhaust pipe, because the other one was all rotted out up by the donut. So pretty excited about that to go on there. See how that goes. And we'll probably end up putting a muffler and a tailpipe on it. But this will get us going, right, Duff? You had fun running around out there. You got, look at all the cacklebirds you got. So many cacklebirds. I love picking those out of your fur. You love it even more than me. All right, throttle linkage. Get back to it. So knocking this bracket apart actually went surprisingly well. Didn't get any blood blisters, no parts went flying, nothing really got damaged. So you can see these two parts used to be flush. Moved it over, oh, about an inch or so, just about the width of that bracket. And now you can see the cables in a straight line. A nice free movement there. And then our spring isn't quite lined up. It's kind of a little bit of an angle, but once we get this welded up, stiffened up, we might be able to work that over a little bit. I wonder if that wasn't tweaked from the last whodanks that messed with it. So I'm gonna weld that. I think I'll tack it first, make sure everything's free. I went and ran the pedal from the inside. Everything's good. It's not quite going WFO. I mean, we got about 10 degrees worth of throttle blade we're not getting. Should be good enough. And I think I can heat and bend the pedal in there if I need to. Modify that to get full throw on that. I don't know why that isn't working, but I'm sure 7,000 RPMs will be enough. We don't need to go to the full 7,700 RPMs. Should be okay. We'll burn that with our cute little Miller 140. And then we'll see where we're at from there, and then we'll figure out that bracing. Gonna be real excited. Getting close. Getting close. Duff, come check out my work on this throttle bracket. It's good, I promise. Yeah, you'll approve. Oh yeah.
Cable's nice and straight. Free movement.
The spring is off a little bit, but it's way better than it was. They're tied into the manifold down here. So it's real strong.
That's what I'm talking about.
So that's good enough for the girls I go with. Right, Duff? And now we got this janky choke cable, but I'm done fabricating. Puddin', he would have drilled a bunch of speed holes in it and dimple dyed it, but we ain't got time for that.
Ain't nobody got time for that.
So I think we're pretty much ready to put coolant in it and a battery and see what happens. Oh, and brakes. We got a manual. Hopefully the shifter works. That's pretty janky. All right. Back to work. So I'm laying under this thing, taking the old exhaust off. That didn't take much because it was ready to fall off. Oh, look. Factory 1969 Ford muffler. C9 part number. You see that? Yeah, check it out, though. Look at that nice new exhaust pipe. Things went downhill from there, though. I figured, yeah, let's just grab the drive shaft and see how tight the U-joints and whatnot are. Pretty good. Not bad. But then I noticed the whole rear end was kind of moving. The U-bolts are not tight. I think somebody put these lift blocks in, or maybe those add-a-leafs. So, a couple of clutch dumps. Things would have got real ugly on Duff. Get in there and inspect it out. Yeah. That drive shaft. That's the good part. Oh yeah, these are the floors. Or where they should be. Actually didn't do a terrible job of patching them. Yeah, hello. And then when we were back here getting the tailpipe off, I noticed this ratchet strap, but it's not just any ratchet strap, it's the cheap, cheesy ones. Oh, it's frayed to almost nothing. It's the fuel tank strap. And it's doing a real good job of it. So we should probably address that. And apparently the wheel cylinder is shot over here. Well, apparently they decided to kink the brake line off, but it looks like they did a nice job of it. I usually like to bend them over two or three times and then smash it with a hammer to really pinch her off good, so. Guess we're not gonna have brakes over there. I'm sure these original shocks that the bushings are shot on are just fine. Rear end breather, we don't need that. What is that? That's not even rubber, it's a bit of plastic. Oh God. There you go. Oh, fixed it. Almost. Get on there. Perfect. Got brakes on that side, though. I can't believe that. Oh, both sides. Wow. Sketchy. So I think I'm going to spray some Zep on those and tighten them up. Those straps, they're going to be good enough. And then, yeah, we should bleed some brakes. Oh, big stretch. No, not take a break. Bleed brakes. I don't know if it's getting better or worse. We don't have to bleed the brakes on this wheel because that line has also been pinched off. Pretty awesome, huh, Duff? Yeah. Let's check this one. Well, that one's got the steel line on it, so Looks like we just got brakes on this side, Duff. You're SOL on your side.
I guess we'll check the bleeder on these two, see if we can't get some fluid. What do you think? You're excited.
I'm not so excited. Sketchy.
Why do cowboys have to get all the cool rigs and just run them into the ground and try to fix them?
Moment of truth, Duff. See if them frost plugs leak. If it does, don't lick it up, okay? It's bad for you. Ah! It's already leaking out the thermostat housing. Son of a biscuit. Wish we had a new one of those on hand. Who'd have thunk that chewy, corroded old thermostat housing was gonna leak? It's a slow drip. We'll run her for now. Is that all the coolant this thing takes? A gallon? That can't be right. Suppose there's any brake fluid in it? Here. You. Scrape the big chunks out. Top it off, call it good. It's kind of sketchy because I'm guessing first gear isn't synchronized, so using the transmission to slow us down, we'll have to line up the RPMs. It's a single reservoir master cylinder, and we know that side is disconnected, so any fluid leaks out anywhere, specifically in that corner, because probably a good spot that it's gonna leak. Now we lose all our fluid and all our brakes. Good thing we got that fancy push bar on the front. Should just call it a smash bar. Is that a candy bar? Smash bar? That isn't even a factory seal in there. That's like out of an inner tube or something. Classy. Go pump the brake stuff.
The whole brake scenario just keeps getting better. So good that Duff's camping out for the night. He's like, I want no part of this, right?
Duff, you wanna come point it out, the issue to him? So, got our brakes bled up. So I went to check them out after I got them all bled to see how the pedal feels. Feels pretty good. But as you keep holding on it, the pedal keeps going to the floor real slow. So it's pushing past the wheel cylinder, right, Duff? Yep. Not good. So, I mean, we could just cap this line off and just have one rear brake, but let's live life dangerously. We got a manual transmission that grinds when you put it in first, I'm sure. So, getting pretty close, Duff. I don't know what else we got to do. Put a battery in it. Should fix that hood latch so that when it fails on the side of the road, we can at least get the hood open, right? We're totally gonna neglect that the fuel tank is held in by not even ratchet straps, just some type of, I don't know, slightly better than tarp straps. Did tighten up the U-bolts on the diffy. We got a straight pipe. You're excited about that. I don't know how the wiring is. If it turns over with the key anymore or did. I don't remember. So, yeah, should we put a battery in it? See if it runs still. Okay. So since this thing's a Ford, it's bound and determined to leave us on the side of the road, and that's what Ford stands for. Found on road dead, and there's several other things. If you got a good one, it's first on race day, but that's about the only good one. There's a lot of bad ones. Anywho, we need a hood prop rod, and it looks like there used to be one that stuck in a hole here. And that's what held it up through there. And it kind of hooked over here. So I got this jack for jacking up your scissor jack on a late model. I think we're going to cut it apart at this pivot here. Straighten this out. See if we can't rig something together. Yay, more fabrication.
These are like $20 online. We don't have that kind of money because we're always about to lose the shop around here. Right, Duff?
Yeah.
So I'm gonna go straighten this out, grind this rivet pivot off. See what we can make of this junk. Good enough for the girls I go with.
Man, that almost worked out way too sweet, didn't it, Duff Dog?
Yeah.
So all I did was I knocked out the pin where that pivot was between the two rods, put a 5/16 bolt, the nylock there, and straightened it out. But the diameter of the rod and the hole in the hood isn't quite right, so I'm gonna have to turn that down a little bit because otherwise it's not gonna stay in there and the wind is gonna take it and bad things will happen. And there's the other issue. This clamp here, I believe, is for the battery hold down. I could take it off and just ixnay it, but I think we're gonna want that. So I'm gonna put a little bend in there. Give it a little dippy-doo. And we'll come back and try that again. So we're gonna put a bend in it, and we're gonna whittle that end down. And it's gonna be way good. Probably should have just bought the $20 one online and waited a week. Oh, look at that sweet battery hold down though. Good to go. Even use the adjustable one. Mint!
Bet you guys didn't know this, but I got a lothy. I don't know how to use it, so here we go. Let's give her a whirl. What is this thing, even an atlas? Oh yeah, the old atlas. So I measured that hole, it's about 375 thousandths, and this is about 430, so we're gonna take 50 thousandths off. The reason that I wanna take it off of here and not just hog out that hole in there is if I were ever to make this thing nice, and this thing can go up and whammy into the hood, so I'd have to weld a washer onto it or something so that it can't go all the way through that structure. So we're just gonna whittle it down. Partly because I never use this stupid lothy and I got it. So we'll use it for the one time in 2021. Here we go. You guys can watch me lose my arm, maybe. Good enough for a hack. Now we gotta put a bend in this thing. Hopefully we put a bend in it the right way. Odds are we won't. Or it'll bend in the wrong spot. The way that it's not gonna want to bend. Snap. Ah, I knew it was gonna snap. Son of a biscuit. Seemed like such a great idea, didn't it? Well, now what are we gonna do, Duff? Yeah, I broke it. You seem so happy with me. You wanna weld that on for me? That'd be great. Maybe that's enough, we'll see. It's probably not. Maybe this thing breaking off is a blessing in disguise. Then we can just weld it. It'll be way good, huh, Duff? Probably not. Yeah, that'll be good. I'm gonna straighten this out a bit again. Grind the paint off both these, weld them together. Maybe just tack them first. It'll be fine. Don't weld next to batteries when they're charging. Ask me how I know. Duff, I could use a hand. Burn that thing together. Probably tweak it a little bit. Should be good. You don't like my hood prop rod or what, Duff? That'll do, pig. That'll do.
That'll do, pig. That'll do.
What's next? I suppose we could put that exhaust on that boom tube Brian gave us.
Is that what you want? Is that why you're laying there?
Fine. We'll crawl underneath and finish that up. It'll be way more quieter.
Got our exhaust done. I did get a couple more quarts of coolant to go in the radiator, so should be good enough. I mean, it's 40 degrees out, so shouldn't run too warm. Let's give her a squirt of the old hot sauce and see if it lights off. Hopefully it doesn't rev to the moon and explode.
That's a real nice ignition switch. Should we give her some choke? Why isn't it going? Is it because this wire's not hooked up to anything? Oh, for cheese and rice, we had a new radiator hose in here the whole time. Smooth move, X-Lax. Flooded? Why is it just starting and dying? Tell me what I'm doing wrong. You want to go for a ride, don't you? Oh yeah. You love that word. Okay, okay, hold your horses. Start and then die. How much fuel's in the tank? Is there any in there? Oh, that would be some old car guy stuff right there. Not have fuel in there. I guess we could spend a whole day diagnosing it.
It's amazing what 5 gallons of gas will do for you.
Not much.
I don't think we're getting fuel duffers.
I'm gonna pull this fuel line off the fuel pump. See if we got fuel at the fuel pump. Doesn't look too promising. Can't remember if we had it running off the tank when we ran it last or not. Let's dump some fuel in the tank. And it's running everywhere in that carburetor, apparently. That's no good. Go online, get yourself one of these non-potable water jugs. They work real good for things. Don't tell Greta.
How dare you?
I like them because you can fill up your vehicle with one hand. You don't have to have 4 hands, plus your neighbors, like the cans that Obama drug in, or California, whoever's fault that was. Is it running out on the floor? Yeah, you go check. Duff has that concerned look. I think we're good. Can't even buy a decent gas can anymore, can you, Duff? I've yet to ruin the neck on one of these, but if you do, you just go grab another chunk of 3/4 hose or whatever it is, 5/8. Unlike those slinky ones I had when I was a kid that piss fuel all over on you. Plus, you can seal these up, and you got a spare cap around if you need one. Hopefully that fixed it, huh? Don't forget to fill that up.
Anyway, slingshot engaged.
Slingshot engaged.
Is it flooded? That seems like ignition cutting out.
Whatever it is, isn't the West River Cowboy ignition switch off of a tractor that's wired up in there. Let's just bypass that.
Now let's see if she lights off.
Who would have thought there was an issue with this wiring? I guess we'll be pulling some wires. Pretty smooth.
You can see that thermostat housing weeping a little bit.
Oh yeah. Nice and quiet. Oh yeah. Definitely getting too much fuel.
Is that frost plug weeping? Son of a biscuit. Wonder if we could tap it in a little bit more. Maybe it's because it says China on there.
Well, I guess we gotta fix some wiring, fix a leak, fix another leak. We'll be ready for a drive. You ready to go for an RIDE?
See if the clutch and shift linkage work. Clutch, probably be all right. Didn't look that good with the ship linkage. It's pretty sketchy.
Hissing and angry. Pressure in there, but nothing's warm. Hope we can seal up that freeze plug. That would be annoying. At least that one's easy to get at. Oh, that was definitely too far. Ah, I think we're gonna have to drain the coolant. Fix that frost plug. Put a different one in. That's why you just go buy a new car, not work on rusty old junk.
Well, I think we fixed our frost plug. I don't know if I didn't get it cleaned out good enough, or pounded in too far or what.
Thermostat housing looks good. But after I glued that on there, well, I didn't glue it. I only put silicone on the thermostat side because I knew I'm gonna throw that thing away because it's wasted. I put a new radiator hose on that I found inside. And after I was trying to figure out the wiring, which I still haven't figured out, I got that bypass, I'll show you in a second. Like an idiot, I completely forgot that we had a brand new thermostat housing. And thermostat. And a gasket. So, we can put those on sometime. Or just throw them on the shelf and forget about it. So this wire on the solenoid is supposed to have power when you're cranking it over, so it bypasses the resistor. That wasn't hooked up, so I put an end on it and hooked that up thinking, oh, that's going to resolve my issue. But the thing is, this thing only has power to the ignition when it is cranking over. So I don't know what the deal is. So we just bypassed everything, and I ran a wire from the coil into the cab up to the ignition switch. So I'm just bypassing their old wiring, and it seems like it works. So we'll just have to redo the wiring. It's a disaster. I was looking at it over there by the solenoid. Not good. Farmers should not be allowed to do wiring, right, Duff? Yeah, I just got it bypassed going to the switch here. There's just wires everywhere. I mean, tinfoil on the fuse. That's a classic farmer hack. Gotta have that. I'm guessing that's why the ignition switch was replaced, or that it's laying down there, or maybe they were just too lazy to do it right. But yeah, everything's working now. We'll just have to run a new wire, bypass all that trash. I think I'm gonna try to find a factory Dura Never Spark ignition system to put on here. Seems like it's kind of got a dead spot, and if I gotta go through all the ignition anyway, just as soon whammy a high energy ignition on there, because I mean there's all kinds of room to put a DuraSpark box on here to fail on you. Why not? And then maybe find a factory steel line and not have this crappy rubber hose, or maybe even just find a pre-emissions carbonator to plop on there, because that one's worn out and it just has a lot going on it, and that might be part of the dead spot too. But I think we're ready to rip. Got our coolant leaks figured out. Our wiring is temporarily, permanently fixed. Our brakes are, I don't know, it seems like it's got a brake and a leaky one. So I think we're ready to go for a rip. We should probably put some gas in it. Yeah, that would be a good idea. Only silly Canucks run out of gas and then put it on the lube tube. Nice work, OCG. You know you got her full when it runs out the cap there. Tech tip of the day, OCG. Don't be a wank. Fill your tank. Hold up. No, I swear it runs and drives. Maybe. Over there. Go to your side. Don't hit your head on the steering wheel. That'll hurt. Yeah, these seats suck. I know. We'll find better ones. If anybody's got some better seats, some low back buckets, preferably, they look like they're Mustang seats. I have a set of pony seats too. So if you got a set of Mustang seats, hit me up. Shipping will kill me, but if you got some in the Midwest somewhere, we'll work something out. Was it doing that not start thing again? Great. Oh, what the French? Steering wheel. It's gotta go. Oh man, we didn't make it very far. Ford things. Come on, Napa starter. Stay strong.
Drives the dreams of champions.
Hot diggity dog, Duffy! We got a speedo, 30 miles an hour in second gear. Third rams into your knees, so that's not comfortable. Pretty sure these things were made for guys who are like 5'4". Bell from Wealth, you should get one. Hey, temp gauge even works. 170. Oils, 30 PSI. some new seats, new patio furniture done. Oh, come on, brakes. Turn out there. We're going past donut corner. Gonna need to address the brakes. Oh, they feel good, but they're not. Spins them in reverse. Look at that. 180, not bad. It's freaking nippy out today. Rolling downhill. Stop! Pedal feels so good, but it does nothing. This thing's got went pretty good donuts in a short wheelbase, one would think.
Door handles are backwards. Nice work, Ford.
Yeah, well, jump out then. Gosh, dang dog.
There's no puddles. Other than all the brake fluid running out the left front wheel. Kind of looks like the right front is too, but I think that's just coolant. So, I mean, that's a plus. Hood prop rod still works. Battery only shifted a little bit. Not into the fan, at least. Should probably fix that wiring so that don't go into the fan. Don't see anything smoking. So I don't know what the smell was. Just coolant drained on the new exhaust. And either the fuel leak fixed itself or it all evaporated onto the manifold. Either way. That's fixed. Got any brake fluid left? Oh yeah, only lost, I don't know, a quarter of the reservoir. Even though these brakes don't do anything, they make you feel good when you hit them. Need to fix the dead spot, which really ain't that bad. It's almost like it's coming out of it. Need to fix that wiring. Brakes, definitely gotta fix brakes. Put some straps on the fuel tank. Maybe even get the fuel gauge working. Seats, definitely need addressed. That steering wheel is too small. And I kind of like the look of these, but I don't like the foam ones. And it just, it ain't right. Should probably do something with the shifter because the column's screwed up. And it hits your knee when you put her in third gear. Maybe with the new seats, that'll fix it. And a million other things. Probably find some rockers. Should paint it. I don't know. We ain't painted nothing yet. But it's not leaking coolant, so that's a plus. I mean, all the work we did fix that. And we got new exhaust. Doesn't seem like it's even leaking.
So there you have it. Duff Dog and I got a 1966 Ford Bronco. First year. Useless knowledge for you. Going. It's not too windy. Back on the road after an unknown amount of time. It sounded like it was off the road. Some cowboys got it on the road for a little while. I think they're the ones who put the seats in it. Did a real nice job with the wiring and such. And the fuel tank strap. Probably can acknowledge them for that. But it's back on the road, running, driving. I think I'm gonna hang on to this one for a while. Fix the brakes, put some fuel tank straps in it, look for some seats, fix the shifter, fix the wiring, a lot of things. Kind of want to find some factory bumpers. I don't like these bull bars, so if you need some aftermarket bumpers and you got some OG ones, let's work something out. Email's down in the description. Hit me up. Well, yeah, wanted one of these for a long time. Finally found one that I could afford, and this is what you get for the stuff that I can afford. It ain't that bad, but it's not that good. So I appreciate it. Thank you very much for watching. Check out my other videos. Like, share, subscribe. Check out the other channels that are listed down here in the description. And remember, doesn't matter how you get it done, as long as you're having fun. Thanks for sticking through this one, everybody. Why do Fords have to be such a pain every time? Every stinking time. I think the Camaro was less of a pain than this thing. Ooh, we gotta find some Das Bronco emblems too. And a full top. Anybody's got a full top? Hit me up. I need a full top. Tailgate. We should look for a tailgate because this one is. She is muddy. Real muddy. And a taillight. I don't know if I broke that or was that like that. I don't remember. Throw that hitch away. So good. Bronco things.